Nearly 2,000 years ago, our Creator rose up a son, and he sent him to us to bear witness to the truth. Yeshua told Pilate that it was for this reason that he was sent into the world. Yeshua told us that the truth is his Father's word. Yahweh rose him up in the image of his word, and he sent him to us in the image of his word. He gave him his word for a name. Yeshua lived by every word that proceeded forth from his Father's mouth, and he told the accuser that we must do the same. Folks, this really is simple. You are either walking as our Creator's only begotten Son was manifested to us, or you are walking as a dead person before Elohim's face. Yeshua said in Matthew chapter 8, verse 22, follow after me and let the dead bury their dead. Dead people could not bury others. So he was speaking about live people who are actually dead before his face and his Father's face. And who does this verse say that these walking zombies are? He says that they are those of you who are not walking in the same manner that he walked. Isaiah recorded that Yahweh's two witnesses would magnify his Torah and testify to its magnificence. This is recorded in Isaiah 42, verse 21. Yahweh is well pleased with his two witnesses on account of their righteousness in magnifying the Torah and making it honorable. Our righteousness is not our own righteousness. It is his righteousness. His two anointed sons are in agreement with his righteousness. His word tells us that whosoever even touches the dead is unclean before his face for 7 days. He tells us this in order to teach us that he wants us to be totally separated unto him from all that opposes his righteousness. He tells us that if we refuse to obey his water of separation statute, that we are cut off from being his people. This is recorded in Numbers chapter 19. He that touches the dead body of any man shall be unclean for 7 days. He shall purify himself with it, referring to the water of separation, on the third day, and on the seventh day at even he will be clean. But if he does not purify himself on the third day, then the seventh day he will not be clean. Verse 19 of this chapter tells us that we must be sprinkled on both the third day and the seventh day. Verse 13, whosoever touches the dead body of any man that is dead and does not purify himself defiles Yahweh's tabernacle, and that life will be cut off from Israel because the water of separation was not sprinkled upon him, and he is unclean, and his uncleanliness will remain upon him. The water of separation that is made from the ashes of a red heifer is discussed in the Mystery of the Red Heifer Revealed video. I'll put the link to this video in the video description box below. I'll also put the links to some other related videos there. Again, Yeshua prophesied that everyone who is not following in his footsteps is a dead person. Surely you can acknowledge this. The night before he was killed, he told his disciples in John 14:6, I am the road, or I exist as the road. The road referring to the pathway and the truth and the life. No man can come to the Father except through me. He existed as his Father's word in the flesh. If you cannot accept this very simple reality, there are not words that can describe your obstinacy. John recorded that Yahweh's word was made to exist in the flesh through his only begotten Son. Yeshua exemplified the pathway that we must walk on in order to become his Father's sons. Any other pathway leads to the lake that burns with fire and brimstone. If you are teaching your children or have taught them any other pathway like the blasphemous false salvation doctrines that are found in Christianity, you have exemplified a murderous heart. You have not only touched the dead, you have helped take eternal life away from them. The same is true when you help facilitate one another walking on any other pathway other than the pathway that our Messiah was manifested to us in the flesh. Your doing so is the blood touching blood that Hosea prophesied of. This is discussed in several of these videos. I'll put the links to some of them in the video description box below. Folks, this really is so simple. Our Messiah told us that many are called, but few are chosen. This is because only a few hearkened to his Father's call to come out of the captivity. Only a few chose to follow his only begotten Son's footsteps. And again, Yeshua's footsteps were and are his Father's word. He told us plainly that he did not come to get rid of one punctuation mark from his Father's Torah until heaven and earth pass away. In the following verses, he went on to magnify his Father's instructions. In the following verses, he also told us that whoever does the smallest of his Father's commandments and teaches others to do them would be given the name great by his Father's kingdom. And he told us that whoever does not do them and does not teach others to do them will be given the name least by his Father's kingdom. This is not complicated. The reason why you refuse to accept this is because you are in love with a different image of him and his Father. Your problem is you are in love with make-believe images of them. and make believe blood does not atone for sins. You are in love with the images of them that came from wolves in sheep's clothing, like Saul of Tarsus. Yahweh Elohim's word testifies that Saul is the abomination that stood in his holy place and desolated his chosen people. And he desolated that which he gave to us to set us apart to become as he is. He gave us his word to set us apart to become as he is. Saul's writings desolated our Creator's word. Yeshua told us that we can know the wolves by their fruit. He told us that their fruit would be violation of his father's Torah. Some of you write me and point out that Saul also spoke to keep the Torah. He spoke with a forked tongue like all serpents do. The bottom line is the third of the world that is in the blasphemous religion of Christianity uses Saul's writings to justify your rebellion to Yahweh's Torah. Case closed. If you want to remain a dead person before the Most High's face by not walking in his Torah like his only begotten son walked in it, go ahead and do so. Dying, you will die. If you want to continue to live with and touch the dead now that this statute has been magnified, go ahead and do so. Dying, you will die. It has been magnified at this time because we are at the time of the second Exodus. If you want to continue to not be sprinkled on the third day and on the seventh day, if you have touched the dead, Yahweh's word is clear that you are cut off from being his people. Thus saith Yahweh Elohim, come out of her, my people. Referring to come out of Mystery Babylon, so that you are not partakers of her sins, and so that you do not receive of her calamity.